Hi everyone, my name is Mitch Leitner and I am an application scientist with Nanoscience Instruments. Today, I will be demonstrating how to properly prepare dry powder samples for analysis with the Phenom SEM. This is the third in a series of videos detailing sample preparation, which is the most crucial part of any SEM analysis. Improper sample prep can impact the quality of imaging for our users, so be sure to employ the practices outlined in this series to ensure superb analysis with the Phenom SEM. The previous videos in this series have stressed the importance of proper sample preparation for ideal SEM analysis, but this is even more critical for dry powders. Powders are incredibly small and easily clump together when simply deposited onto an aluminum stub. This makes analyzing individual particles difficult for two reasons. Particles atop the pile will not be adhered to the carbon tape, resulting in these powders flying off the stub. Clumped up particles also overlap with each other, making collection of accurate dimensional and morphological data difficult. Thus, the goal of powder sample preparation is to uniformly distribute the powder across the carbon tape in a single layer. There are numerous methods to prepare powders for analysis with the Phenom SEM, but today I'll be highlighting three simple low-cost options. These are the flick method, the dish method, and drop casting.
The flick method utilizes a wooden cotton swab to disperse particles onto a sample stub. It is my preferred method as it is both simple to execute and effective for any particles smaller than 500 microns. We start by inserting the wooden end of our cotton swab into our powder sample. The particles will attach themselves to the wood, allowing us to easily transport a small volume of powder to our sample stub. If your particles are too large for this method, they will not stick to the wood, but the method can be used on particles that do adhere. Using our particle-covered swab, we can then deposit the particles by hovering the swab over top of our sample stub and then striking it with a quick flick. Applying such an abrupt force dislodges and aerosolizes the particles, resulting in an even distribution of particles on the stub. To finish the preparation, we remove any loose particles from the stub by blasting it with a canister of compressed air. Next, we'll take a look at the dish method. For particles ranging from 500 microns to 1 micron in size, the dish method of sample preparation is an excellent option. It is incredibly simple to execute, even more so than the flick method. We start by emptying some of our powder sample into a petri dish. We can then spread this powder out by gently shaking the dish back and forth or by using a spatula. We can then grab our aluminum stub with carbon tape and then lightly apply it to the dispersed powder. This ensures a nice, even distribution of particles across the surface of the stub. Tap the side of the stub to the edge of the petri dish to dislodge any extra particles. And then we can remove the rest of them using the can of compressed air, just like we did with the flick method. This sample is now ready for analysis. The extra powder inside of the petri dish can then be used to prepare more sample stubs or return to its original container. Now let's talk about drop casting. The final method I'll be demonstrating is called drop casting, which is used for particles that are less than a micron in diameter. This technique involves mixing a powder into a solvent, most commonly isopropyl alcohol or ethanol, and then casting said solution onto a substrate. The solvent will then evaporate and leave the powder behind, creating a uniform distribution of particles. Dropcast particles are held to the surface by van der Waals forces, so a flat, featureless surface is an ideal substrate. You can cast larger particles directly onto carbon tape stickers, but if the particles are too small, they can sink into the surface, making examination of their morphology difficult. Creating a solution is quite simple. You'll need a vial, a pipette, your powder, a metal spoon, and a solvent. We'll start by loading our vial with powder. We don't need a large amount of powder to create a solution, so just fill the tip of the metal spoon with powder and then deposit into the vial. We can then load our solvent until the solution is nearly clear. To ensure the best possible dispersion in the solution, we can sonicate the vial. But if you do not have a sonicator, vortexing the sample or shaking it vigorously can also work. From here, we can now prepare our sample stub. We'll grab an aluminum stub with carbon tape and a silicon wafer. This is the standard substrate material for drop casting. We'll then grab a pipette to draw out some solution from the glass vial and cast directly onto the silicon wafer. We'll then allow our solution to fully evaporate before completing the final sample preparation step, which will be to blow off the sample with a canister of compressed air, just like with every other sample preparation method. I hope this video helped you gain insight into the ideal sample preparation methods for dry powders in the Phenom SEMs. Stay tuned for more videos in the Phenom SEM sample preparation series, and if you have any questions about Phenoms, please contact us. See you in the next video.